Good evening. My name is, Steve Allen. And we have with us Miss, who is first here? Olivia De Havilland and Bette Davis, and they have a secret.
I've Got a Secret, brought to you by Green Whip, the whip topping mix of all the flavor richness of whipped cream from General Foods. From New York, here is I've Got a Secret, starring Steve Allen.
Thank you. Why, it's the wrong woman. Good evening and welcome to I've Got a Secret. Now, I'll tell you right away, this young lady on my arm is Lorraine Bloy. And she is the young lady who was selected from our studio audience last week to be our guest panelist tonight, sitting in for vacationing Bess Myers. So, Lorraine, when you're not being a panelist on I've Got a Secret, what do you do?
I'm a stewardess for Pan American World Airways.
I see. Well, then let me formally introduce you to your fellow passengers on our little flight this evening. First, we have Henry Morgan. And then sitting in for Bill Cullen as the star of the Broadway hit I Had a Ball, Buddy Hackett. And next to Buddy is lovely Betsy Palmer. That's our panel, Lorraine, and I just want you to sit right there now. Don't be a bit nervous, because if anything goes wrong, Buddy and Henry are on either side of you, and I'm sure they'll do what they can to help you out, right?
Have no fear.
Anytime you figure you're stuck for an answer, kiss me. You'll give me a signal, you know that. Hey, Steve, you know what I found out?
What's that, Buddy?
Yeah, you know, we picked Lorraine by slipping a slipper on her foot, and whoever had the best fit. If she didn't have the gout, she wouldn't have been on tonight.
Well, we'll see how she does. So let's bring in our first contestant, please. Nice to see you. Make yourself comfortable there, and would you tell us your name and where you're from?
My name is Frank Paxton, and I am from New York City.
All right, Mr. Paxton, if you'll whisper your secret to me, we'll show everybody just what it is. Well, sir, a little more to that, I understand. Uh-huh. My goodness. That's something. Panel, the clue to Mr. Paxton's secret concerns something that is happening, and we'll start the game with Henry Morgan. Something he can do? Something he can do that is happening while he does it.
Huh?
They decided it's something he can do, but it's also happening. It'll happen if he does it.
You want to go first? Mr. Paxton, this thing you can do, you're going to do tonight, I imagine.
Right here.
Right here. Marvelous. Do you use anything, any kind of equipment when you do it?
No props at all.
Barehanded, eh? Is it a physical thing that you do?
No.
Mental?
Yes.
Do you answer questions?
Yes.
Of a particular kind?
Yes.
You're sort of a mental wizard.
Right.
Very good, Henry. $20 down, 60 to go. We go to Miss Bloy.
Do you do this for a living?
Yes.
Do you have your business in New York?
Yes.
However, that might confuse you, because what he does, he can do anywhere.
Yes.
It's all right to faint, Lorraine, if you want to. You don't really have to ask all those questions.
And you thought we got paid for nothing, didn't you?
My hands are shaking so much, I think she's waving at me.
It has to do with his mind.
Well, does it have something to do with your mind?
Yes.
Very good, Lorraine. All right, there is apparently half the money. The other half remains. We go now to Buddy Hackett.
This mind that it has something to do with, is that kept in your head?
Yes.
And at no time we assume that this ever leaves the body.
A reasonable assumption.
You don't do any astral teleportation or anything like that, you know?
No.
This thing that you do it for a living. You do a mind-reading act?
Not a mind-reading act.
Oh, but you do... Do you read minds?
No.
No.
Oh, then you have some kind of a mental compulsion that you
That's the word, yes.
You are a mental compulsion. Hey, what is this here?
The light changed, buddy. $60 down and 20 to go. Now it's Betsy Palmer's turn.
Mr. Paxton, by any chance, do you retain whatever you hear,
yes,
if you concentrate on it? And are you going to repeat all the questions that we have asked you?
No, I'm not going to try that tonight.
You're not going to try? Oh, but you could do that.
But I do. Yes, I do things like
that.
Well,
you haven't heard people's names in the audience, have you?
No.
No? There's something, though, that you have retained.
Yes.
Something that we...
Yes, he has retained an attorney to sue all of you for not getting his secret. No, seriously, that blows the money, but Mr. Paxton is a vaudevillian who has spent the past 35 years touring this country with a really amazing act. He has committed to memory names of hotels, theaters, newspapers, and several other facts about almost every city in the United States. Isn't that something? Now, Mr. Paxton is obviously a very remarkable man. All of us in the studio have already discovered that because a little earlier today, we were throwing names at him just at random, and we haven't been able to stick him yet. Maybe somebody can, but I don't think so. Buddy, let's start with you. Just pick any town. Let me explain one thing so you won't pick a little tiny village nobody ever heard of. It has to have maybe 20,000 people or so that it will have a newspaper, have a couple of hotels, that sort of thing. But name any town and see how he does.
Oh, what clubs can you play in Erie, Pennsylvania?
Erie's a very nice city, yes. Erie City Times is the paper there. And, Buddy, if you were going to play the club, you would play the old Press Club. Is that the one you're thinking of?
No.
The Press Club? Well, that's the best one. The Moose Club is right there.
Moose,
right on the square there. Yes, the Moose Club is right on the square. I'll give you the hotel. There's a little club there, Buddy, called the Lawrence. That's one of the United Hotel chains. I think that's one of the remaining hotels. And then where all the acts stay is the Rich Ford, right across the park there. There's a Warner Theater and a Shea Theater, the remaining theaters.
Wonderful.
Well, a lot of bowlers there. Erie City Boiler, Hammer Mill Bond.
Yeah. Actually, we have
to say one thing, though.
Yes.
You can prove it with me because I've never been there.
Believe it or not.
Believe
it or not, we actually have to slow Mr. Paxton down because he can do 25 minutes about one city. Betsy, name another town.
How about my hometown?
City? Is it?
It's East Chicago, Indiana.
East Chicago, yes.
That's near Gary.
It's the big steel mills are there and everything. Gary, of course, has the steel mills there. But I'll give you the hotel. It's the Elks Hotel.
Yes,
that's really
right.
A tough one, too. The Elks
Very
Hotel. All right. Betty, Sinclair Refining Company. That's the big thing there.
That's
Sinclair Refining.
Is.
Yeah, I had to think of that.
You are sure. Right. My gracious, that's amazing.
Henry, let's see if you can stick Mr. Paxton.
Mr. Paxton, name five cities that don't have a Hilton.
Well, that's a new game, Henry.
Biloxi, Mississippi.
Biloxi? That's the shrimp center. Yeah, the shrimps. Let me see. Buddy, the Herald, it comes over from the Gulfport. It's right on the Gulf there. I'll give you the hotel, and I'll see if I get them right. The Buena Vista Hotel, and the White House Hotel, and the Tivoli Hotel.
Very good. The fact that Miss Bloy is a stewardess puts her in a good spot here to maybe stump Mr. Paxton. Try it.
Well, I'll take my hometown, Long Beach, California.
Oh, Long Beach, California. I have to keep up with the papers because there's a consolidation of papers there. The Independent and the Press-Telegram, is that right? Yeah.
Right.
Let me see the hotel, I think the Breakers International would be called now. New Pike is the amusement park there. I would have to give you some. I'll give you the theaters in a minute. Let me see what hotels are left. The Lafayette Hotel and the Blackstone Hotel and the Maryland Hotel are there. I know that. The Robinson Hotel. Let me see how the theaters would run. The old Strand Theater used to play vaudeville. Yeah, that's gone. I heard about that the other day. That would leave the Imperial Theater, the United Artists Theater, and the Crest Theater, and the Rick, and the Belmont Theater, the Atlantic Theater, the Ridley Theater, and the Blackstone Theater.
You have time for just one? We were going to throw this out to the audience, but the clock man says we only have time now to ask one person out there We could do this all night. He could, I mean. What do I mean, we? Let's see. Johnny Olson, just pick anybody at random, and would you give the name of any town, miss, please?
Richmond, Virginia.
Richmond, Virginia.
Richmond, Virginia. Newsleader, Times, Dispatch, the Paper, Lee Hotel, the John Marshall Hotel, the Jefferson Hotel, the theaters there, Lowe's, and the National Theater there. For near every tobacco center in the world is also University of Richmond, the state capital. How's that?
Yeah. Okay. Thank you so much. He ought to have his own show. It's a pretty wild idea. Anyway, we'll be right back again in just a moment. But first, let's watch this.
Welcome to the Taylor Ranch, where days start with an early morning ride and a good pot of coffee.
Good because I make it a special way. Let me show you. I make it by the pot. With Instant Maxwell House, using this recipe. 1 teaspoon per cup, cold water, heat almost to a boil, then let it steep.
Great coffee. You know, some men are just lucky.
Some women are, too.
Instant Maxwell House. Now so much richer, you can make it by the pot.
Miss Bloy, you're really doing a wonderful job. Let's see how you do with our next group of contestants. Here they come. Gentlemen, make yourselves comfortable there, and would you tell us your names and where you're from?
Robert Jordan, Mahwah, New Jersey.
Robert Jordan from New Jersey, and you, sir?
Robert Jordan from Washington Township, New Jersey.
Again, Robert Jordan. Well, panel, despite the fact that these gentlemen are both named Robert Jordan, and they live only a few miles away from each other in New Jersey, they never met, nor did they know about each other. And then one day, about a week ago, a remarkable coincidence brought them together. So, gentlemen, did you two, Robert Jordans, how did you two Robert Jordans finally meet each other?
That's our secret.
Just as I thought. Okay, if you'll whisper that to me, we'll let the audience at home know what's up. Uh-huh. Now, what were you doing there? I see. Panel, the clue to Robert Jordan's secret, and also Robert Jordan's secret, concerns the circumstances under which they met. And we'll start the game this time with Buddy Hackett.
Montreal, Canada. Right. Can you... Oh, I thought they'd get...
Wrong man.
...things too hard. Oh. Now, as your secret has got some... If I know where you met, would I have a pretty good idea what your secret is?
Indeed.
Oh, I would say, just taking a rough guess, that you both... Wives were expecting babies. You met in the maternity hospital, and you saw opposite children, and you were switched kids on you. And you saw the wrong kids. Each one showed you. One had a boy, one had a girl, and they brought you the boy, and they brought him the girl. Is that right?
And that concludes our program this evening, ladies and gentlemen. That's almost it.
Did I guess it? I didn't guess it? Then I quit. I don't want to be here anymore.
You've just about got it, Buddy. However, not quite. So that's $20 down, 60 to go. And Betsy?
Well, I'm so confused. I, too, thought maybe because of the ladies' reaction in the audience when they went, oh, that these gentlemen did meet in a maternity ward.
Uh-huh.
Now, is it that you both had the same, like, triplets or twins? Or something
yes.
like that?
It's really fast work. Panel, Robert Jordan over here went to the Pascack Valley Hospital last week to visit his wife, who had just presented him with twins. And that is where he met this Robert Jordan, who was at the Pascack Valley Hospital visiting his wife, who, as you've already guessed, Betsy, had presented him with twins.
I thought I'm making up a fantastic tale.
Well, I don't think any two gentlemen could meet under more pleasant circumstances. Your wives had rooms right across the hall from each other. Is that right?
That's right.
I see. And did you know each other? I mean, did you get to know each other before the babies were born?
Never knew each other.
I before. See. Was there a lot of confusion around the hospital about having all these little Jordan babies all of a sudden?
Well, slightly, but they coped with the situation quite well.
I see. Well, we have a newspaper picture here, which we borrowed from a paper. I'll have to have Mr. Paxton come back and tell me what paper, I guess. And it shows the proud fathers and their children. Who's who here and what's what?
This is I. And I am holding my son in my right. That's Scott Robert and my daughter, Sandra Rose.
And?
Being I have two girls, I'll make a guess. This is Roberta and Angela.
I see. We unfortunately have no pictures of the proud mothers because we didn't want to bother them in the hospital with photographers. But, gentlemen, it was an amazing coincidence. Sorry you weren't out here longer. Our panel was just too smart for us tonight. But congratulations to you and to your wives. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you very much.
And now, through the magic of television, here's the vacationing Bill Cullen with a word for people who want to build better bridges. Or a play better bridge, or something like that. Take it away, Bill.
Well, let's see, three spades or three no trump. Actually, my tip is for the ladies, and it's this. I can't tell you how to play the cards, but I can tell you how to make your bridge party dessert a winner every time. You serve it with delicious Dream Whip. Now, maybe you wonder if you'd dare use Dream Whip instead of whipped cream for such a special dessert. Well, let me tell you, you certainly can, because Dream Whip has all the flavor richness of whipped cream. Real country fresh flavor. And Dream Whip whips up smooth and creamy every time. Dream Whip, the whipped topping mix, stays fresh on your shelf, ready to use anytime you need it. And say, let's take a look at that. Does it make you as hungry as it makes me? And Dream Whip has only 14 calories to a tablespoon. For your next party and every time you make dessert, remember Dream Whip, the one with all the flavor richness of whipped cream.
And now it's time to meet again our special guests for tonight, two of America's most distinguished actresses. Moviegoers will soon have the rare pleasure of seeing both of them starring in one movie. It's the new motion picture called Hush, Hush, Sweet Charlotte. Here now are Miss Bette Davis and Miss Olivia De Havilland. Folks, get a hand, but that was an ovation, ladies, and I know you appreciate that. Now, it's something quite interesting is going to happen, panel. Now that you ladies have had a look at the panel and the panel has had a good look at you, I'm going to ask the panel to put on blindfolds. You'll find them right in front of you, panel. There you are.
Why don't we put on blindfolds when the fellas were here? Well, look at the girls.
And now... Everybody in the dark over there? Okay, now, Miss Davis and Mr. Havilland, if you'll whisper your secret to me, we'll show it at the same time to our audience at home.
Uh-huh.
See? Well, I think I see what you have in mind, and we'll see how it goes. Ladies, panel, the clue... to Bette Davis and Olivia De Havilland's secret concerns something that is happening, and we'll start the questioning with Buddy Hackett.
Something that is happening right now?
Mm-hmm.
Am I allowed to look?
Not just yet.
Oh.
You can ask, put your questions to either one of our guests.
Well, Miss Davis, if I wasn't wearing a blindfold, would I then be able to know what it was that was happening?
Yes.
Well, that certainly helps me a lot. And this thing that is happening now, is this something that you've done before?
Well, no, it isn't, but I do enjoy it.
It sounds very different to me now. This thing that you enjoy, would I enjoy doing that?
Probably.
All right, $20 down, 60 to go.
I didn't find out anything, and the horn came.
Betsy?
Mr. Havilland, are you doing the same thing as Miss Davis?
Yes.
Miss Davis, is it something physical that's happening to you?
No.
Was that Miss Davis or Mr. Havilland?
Well, that was Mr. Havilland, I'm sorry.
That was Mr. Havilland?
Yes, you asked.
Miss Davis, is anything physical happening to you?
No.
Is anything mental happening to both of you?
Well, No.
Is anything... You are doing something, Miss De Havilland?
Yes, I am. of a physical nature.
All right, panel's quite mystified here. There goes half the money. We go now to Henry Morgan. No.
Hey, Betty, you mixed me up a lot.
Betty, I'll bet you.
Your turn, Hank.
You mixed me up plenty with them.
Henry.
But.
Oh, yes. Oh. It gets dark in there, doesn't it?
I. Miss Davis, are you performing any function?
No, I'm not.
Mr. Havilland, are you doing something?
No.
Is something happening to you?
No.
Now, that's odd. So far, we've covered that it's not physical. It's not mental. You know, nobody's doing anything to anybody. And nobody's doing anything to you.
Nobody's doing anything to you either, Henry, so... Steven, you know.
Not inside my head, that's for sure.
Just a little bit of money left. Miss Bloy, let's see how you do.
What does this have something to do with the voices which are changing, Miss Davis?
Yes.
Huh, I got it.
What is it?
You got it, as a matter. Well, just follow
Keep
what you're
going.
Doing. You're quite right.
I don't know what to ask now about the voices.
Well, how did you like the first question? Now, remember what you, remember what you just said.
Are you switching voices? Miss De Havilland?
I beg your pardon.
Miss De Havilland, are you switching voices?
No.
There isn't another person on the stage outside, the two of you, Steve Allen.
All right, panel. That substantially is it. You may now remove your blindfolds.
I said somebody doing their voices.
Young lady, will you tell the panel what the secret is?
Well, the secret is that they haven't opened their mouths, and I'm doing all the talking for them.
Yes.
It's been a gag.
Actually, it could only happen, and I've got a secret here. We have Bette Davis and Olivia De Havilland, two marvelous actresses, and we don't let either one of them open their mouths.
It's a miracle you accomplished it.
Of course, I'm sure just about everybody recognizes the brilliant comedian who plays Christine Clam on the Jackie Gleason show, Miss Barbara Heller. Betty, do you think she captured you?
Barbara has been doing me for many years, and I think it's really extraordinary imitation. Thanks, yeah. I really do.
Indeed it is. Mr. Havilland, has anyone ever done you before?
Not that I know of, and I have trouble doing myself.
Well, Barbara, I congratulate you on a brilliant job, which you always turn in, and thank you so much for helping us fool the panel tonight.
Thank you.
Well, I know that everybody's looking forward, ladies, to the opening of your new motion picture, Hush, Hush, Sweet Charlotte, which I understand opens in New York this week. Is that correct?
Yes. And Wednesday, I believe. At the Capitol, I believe.
Very good. All right. Well, now we believe it, too. And I'm sure that you're all, you're both, I should say, very excited about all the Academy Award nominations the pictures received, huh?
Seven.
That's wonderful.
We are thrilled. Of course, we're thrilled to death for Agnes Moorehead. For the supporting woman, you know, and needless to say, she will have our vote.
Wonderful. Olivia, what role do you play in the picture?
Well, I do not play Hush Hush, contrary to belief. Uh-huh. I play a mysterious cousin, Miriam, of Charlotte.
I see.
You can guess who Charlotte is.
I see. By the process of elimination, yes, I can. Betty, is it true that you sing in this movie?
Well, I do a song that my lover, who died when I was very young, left to me of his love for me, and I sing it one night in a room alone, remembering him. Yes.
I see. How does she do, Olivia?
I think she sings it most effectively. Why don't you ask her to do it now?
Well, as a matter of fact, we... we are going to be that presumptuous. In fact, we've... overconfidently, perhaps, ask the band to sneak around and get in the center of our stage. So, Bette, if you'll help yourself to our microphone, our stage,
Thank
and our orchestra. This is something quite rare in television. Here is Bette Davis herself.
Hush, hush, sweet Charlotte. Charlotte, don't you cry. Hush, hush, sweet Charlotte. I love you till I die. Oh, hold me, darling, please hold me tight and brush that tear from your eye. You weep because you had a dream last night. You dream that I said goodbye. Hush, hush, sweet Charlotte, Charlotte, don't you cry. Hush, hush, sweet Charlotte, I love you till I die. I hold two roses within my hand, two roses I give to you. The red rose tells you of my passion, and the white rose, my love so true. And every night after I shall die, yes, every night when I'm gone, the wind will sing to you this lullaby. Sweet Charlotte, was love by John.
Olivia, have you two had fun with us today?
Gee, baby, it sure has been a wild show. It sure has been a wild show. I hope it turned the audience on with my act. Ain't it a gas? I mean, ain't it a flip?
Whose voice is that?
Barbara Heller.
Ah.
Ring-a-ding-dinger.
A little bit of a
great big hit of a new kind of hairstyling comb. And it's free.
Yes-a-ree.
With self-styling adorn.
Adorn.
With a bikini comb, you can feather your hair faster. These tiny teeth really grip. To make the feathering stay, spray with Adorn, the water-free hairspray. It holds up to twice as long. Now smooth. A bikini comb smooths best because tiny teeth don't go deep, can't pull out the feathering. Finishing touch, Adorn, the water-free hairspray that builds shape and holds it. Get a bikini comb free and a styling book. See?
With self-styling Adorn.
Adorn.
All we have time to do is say goodnight to this lovely panel, goodnight to this nice audience. See y'all next week.
From Jell-O pudding and high filling. Banana cream flavor. It's got real banana flakes right in the box for richer, creamier banana taste. Now banana cream pie has banana taste all through. Banana pudding does too. More luscious banana recipes on the package. It's a swinging new flavor. New banana cream flavor. Jell-O pudding and pie filling.
I've Got a Secret has been brought to you tonight by
Jell-O pudding and pie filling and instant Maxwell House coffee, both fine products from General Foods.
This program was pre-recorded. This is John Tanner speaking.